Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name's Alex. I make videos about my college experience at Tulane, and today I'm going to talk about how to get into Tulane University. So yeah, let's get on with the video. So this is a video that Tulane would never ever release, so I guess I'm pretty excited to put together this video. So I came up with 5 tips to help you get into Tulane University, and if you find this video anywhere remotely helpful, be sure to subscribe because future videos are going to have more tips as well as tips to get additional scholarships at Tulane. So yeah, press that subscribe button and yeah, let's get on. So the number one tip is show demonstrated interest. Tulane is one of the highest schools that puts a lot of emphasis on demonstrated interest. So that means that if you don't show that you really want to go to the school, then you're probably not gonna get in. I have a few friends and some other people that I know that had much higher stats. They're probably more qualified than I was to get into Tulane, but at the end of the day, they didn't show as much interest as I did wanting to attend the university. So how can you show demonstrated interest? The number one way is apply either early decision or early action. So Tulane receives about 44,000 applications every year, and we have a current acceptance rate of 11%. And of that 11%, 27% were admitted through early decision. So yeah, obviously applying early decision or early action definitely helps. But I'd like to stress that if you apply early decision, then the likelihood of you receiving additional scholarships is much lower relative to if you applied early action instead. To further this point, regular decision has an acceptance rate of 1%. So that means that you have a higher likelihood of getting into Harvard University than into Tulane if you apply regular decision instead. And additionally, you can't apply for any of the additional scholarships if you apply regular decision, so I don't know why you would choose to apply RD. So definitely apply early action or early decision. If you truly believe that Tulane is going to be your dream school and you can see yourself here, then by all means apply ED, but early action is definitely my suggestion. So the second way to show demonstrated interest is write your Why Tulane essay. So the Why Tulane essay is optional, but if you don't do it, then you're pretty much guaranteed not to get into Tulane. So definitely write your Why Tulane essay, and it could be about literally anything. If you have alumni in your family, then write about that. If you find my YouTube channel inspirational, then you can write about that. Some students have already done that. Yeah, you could write about the weather. I actually read out my Why Tulane essay in this video right here, so check it out if you want a little bit of inspiration, but definitely make yours a little bit more unique because mine was kind of boring. A third way to show demonstrated interest is contact your admissions counselor, kind of show that you're interested in the school. But first, do your research. Don't just aimlessly like ask them questions. Do your research and ask specific questions about like special programs that Tulane may offer. Yeah, they don't want to be bombarded with random questions that you could probably just Google and find out. So definitely do your research beforehand. Yeah, every time you contact the school, it goes into a file and people can look at that a little bit later. So don't bombard them with emails, but be very strategic in how you ask your questions. So the fourth way to show demonstrated interest is request an interview. So in Tulane's interview was actually my first college interview, and it's just a great way to talk to a Tulane graduate and kind of get to know their experience, but also it shows that you're genuinely interested in getting to know what more about the school. And then the fifth way to show demonstrated interest, which you may not be able to do depending on the circumstances as well as COVID-19's travel restrictions, but it is to visit the campus. Be sure to sign up for a tour, maybe Destination Tulane or another special program. Just be sure to notify the admissions that you are coming so that they can put that into the file afterwards. So the second tip to get into Tulane University is apply for the scholarships. I have a scholarship video right here where I go into a little bit more in depth, but definitely apply to the Paul Tulane, Dean's Honors, Community Service Fellows, and the Stamp Scholarships. I can't stress that enough. Not only does that show more demonstrated interest, but like, who doesn't want free money? So Tulane takes two personal statements. The personal statement that goes through the Common application, as well as your Y2 Lane essay. And you may be a little bit disappointed. You'd be like, ah, gosh, that doesn't really give me the opportunity to show Tulane what I have to offer to the school. So if you apply to the scholarships, then the personal statements that you write for the scholarships go into your file, and that's an extra piece of content that the admissions committee can actually review. So as a community service fellow, I actually get to review some of the incoming applications for the scholarships, which is, I guess, pretty cool. And when I'm going through the essays, the personal statements, and the resumes, I kind of paint a picture of the student and see if I could see them, you know, at Tulane University. When I'm going through these essays, I can kind of see some people painting a facade, which isn't great, but at the same time, I can see students who are actually genuine, passionate, and humble about the service that they do. So when you're putting together these scholarship applications, definitely reflect your character, and be humble, genuine, and passionate about whatever you do. And on top of that, another scholarship you can apply to is the Dean's Honor Scholarship. And this one's actually pretty cool because you can submit a video. So some people say that a video or a picture is worth 1,000 words. So let's say you submit a 3-minute video, then that's several hundreds and thousands of worth of words. So definitely submit a video or maybe a picture or some other artistic way to show what you can offer at Tulane and be as creative as you can. So yeah, I guess applying to the scholarships definitely gives the admissions committee additional substance to look at you in a very more holistic perspective when you're applying to Tulane. So the third tip is kind of short, but it is get as many letters of recommendation sent to Tulane as possible. I think you can get up to 6 letters of rec sent, and on top of that, through the scholarships, then you can also get more letters of rec put into your file. So yeah, the letters of rec can literally be from anyone, like your teachers, coaches, primary investigators if you did research, your job, part-time job supervisor, literally anyone that will write just a little bit or a lot about you. And when I was going through my admissions file, I was flipping through, and honestly, your essays are just like 2 pages. But if you can get your letters of rec to be submitted, let's say someone writes 1 page or even 2 pages, that can be from 6 to 12 additional pages of content that the admissions committee can review. And honestly, the letters of rec really paint a picture of what type of student you are, and that's what admissions wants to see. So get as many letters of rec sent to Tulane as you can through the Common App as well as through the scholarships. So the fourth tip is get your extracurriculars into check, but don't do things for the resume because that's just not the way to do it, because honestly, the admissions council can kind of see through that. They can see that you're not actually passionate about it. So definitely do things that you're passionate about. With that being said, get a few leadership positions. You don't have to be the president of your National Honor Society, but I would say that try getting an officer position in something that you're passionate about, whether that's Animals Alliance, Health Occupation Students of America, HOSA, or DECA, or band, or orchestra. I just can't, there's an unlimited amount of high school activities I can do, but try to get a leadership position and dedicate a lot of time into growing that organization and making it better. So something that colleges all love is well-roundedness. So let's say you play a sport or an instrument, be sure to reflect that into your activities page in the Common App, or maybe write your personal statement about that, but show that you're well-rounded. You play a sport, you play an instrument, you have strong academics, so well-roundedness is also key. So a lot of you guys may know that Tulane is ranked #1 in community service. So I think it'd be kind of helpful to volunteer a little bit. That was something that I did a lot in high school, and that's why I reflected a lot in my application. So yeah, volunteer pretty much anywhere. Just put the hours in and try to also maybe pursue a leadership position that, but make sure it's something you're passionate about. So let's say that you're interested in healthcare, then volunteer at a hospital. Maybe you want to help the hungry, so then volunteer at a food pantry. Or maybe you just want to do more fundraisers through those organizations at school that you're super passionate about. So yeah, anything works. Just put the hours in and yeah, help out your community. So another component of extracurriculars is get a job. So Jeff Schiffman, the director of admissions of Tulane University, explicitly said in an Instagram video that he values students who have jobs. So they're very humbling experiences. So if you can't get that research position at the medical center, then get a job at like a restaurant. I actually worked at Texas Roadhouse and Chick-fil-A for 3 long years. And yeah, it was just a humbling experience, and I guess it showed admissions committees that I'm willing to put in the work and put in the extra time. A lot of the times, the students who apply to these universities, they aren't in the top 1%. There aren't that 1% of students who can go to Africa and do like a service trip. I mean, those are great rewarding experiences, but that's very atypical for the average student applying to university. So yeah, get a job, and Tulane will not overlook that at any means. So yeah, getting a job is always helpful as well. So the fifth tip is something that I didn't really want to talk about, but if I'm going to talk about how to get into Tulane, then I guess I gotta talk about it. But that is, get your GPA, ACT or SAT, as high as possible. So the average ACT at Tulane was just released, and it is 32. And yeah, because of COVID-19, Tulane is actually not requiring the ACT or SAT for the next round of admissions, which I guess could be a good thing or a bad thing. I'm not entirely sure. Yeah, I don't know your circumstance, whether or not it should be advantageous or disadvantageous to submit your ACT, but I guess that's your call at the end of the day. So when I was going through my admissions file, I was looking at my ACT, and Tulane does not super score. But what they do is they take the highest score in every subject and they list that instead, as well as your highest composite score. And obviously your highest composite score is gonna have the most weight, but it's kind of nice that Tulane takes into account your highest score in each section. But yeah, if you can get your ACT up, that's great. Tulane also looks at the rigor of classes that you take. Don't just load up on APs and sacrifice your GPA. Tulane is definitely looking at students who take rigorous course loads, and they're challenging themselves in AP classes, but they also wanna see students who are very well-rounded. So let's say you wanna take an art class instead of your AP, that AP class that you have no interest in, then take the art class. Get a little bit more of that experience that makes you happy. And maybe you can write about that in your personal statements. It's all fair game at that point. So at the end of the day, Tulane actually computes a numerical value for the quality and the academic rigor of your high school. And they also take into account your ACT and SAT, as well as your GPA, and they put this all together into some algorithm, and they give you a numerical value from 0 to 100 on overall academic, I think it's called the academic index. The whole point of this academic index isn't necessarily to rank the students, but they want to see that you're able to handle the academic rigor of Tulane. Tulane is not an easy school. They do have rigorous classes. They want to make sure that the students can not only handle rigorous course load in high school, but they want to see if you can bring that into college and also handle that course load. So I don't want to put too much stress on the numbers. The numbers are just numbers. Tulane is very holistic in evaluating the students, but the numbers are pretty important when going through the applications. So get them as high as you can, and yeah, hopefully that helps you out. So I hope you guys found this video is like remotely helpful, and if you did, please subscribe. And I'm definitely coming out with more content that both caters to the interests of the prospective students as well as the current students that are gonna be attending Tulane in the fall of 2020. So definitely subscribe and check those videos out. If you enjoyed, drop a like, share it with someone that may be interested in Tulane, and I'll catch you in the next one. Peace.